All right, so I'm sitting inside of a 2018 Honda Accord. This is actually the base model hybrid. And I'm just gonna walk you through and explain how some different things work. So let's start you over on the left side of the car and we'll walk across the dash and explain the car. So right here, you'll notice you do have the auto up down windows on your driver and passenger side. They're all powered. Above that, your window locks and then your door locks. Your mirror control, so left and right, and then your pad. Jumping over to the dash. So this actually controls all your Honda sensing features. This will bring them up in the screen. So if I press this, you're gonna notice this screen come up. And then from here, I could scroll through and turn some different things on and off. So road departure mitigation, collision mitigated braking system, things like that. So that's how this works. So I'm gonna jump back out of this screen. I'm scrolling down to exit. Down below that, you'll see vehicle stability assist. This works with your traction control. So this is set up in the event that you go into a skid, it'll transfer power to whichever wheel has more traction to help correct the skid. So that's how this works. This is always on unless you press it and hold it for 3 to 4 seconds to turn it off. Moving up, so your trips, this is where you can get to them and reset them, some different things, unless you wanna do it via the screen up here and do it with some buttons. So just different ways to do different things. Obviously AC unit. Moving up to the screen. So the screen that you see on the left where the tachometer would normally be, right now you can see a power flow. So this will show you how the car is actively working, whether it be strictly electric in hybrid mode, pure gasoline. So it's just kind of a nice feature. On the home button right here on the deal, if I press that, it pulls up all my different menus. So you can see that you have a lot of different menus. For the hybrid, this menu, and this menu are all gonna be separate from what you would see from a normal Accord. So as far as like power and charge, this is the general screen that I had pulled up. One down Eco Drive, so you can see as far as how you're driving, as far as economically friendly to you. One down Power Flow, that's what I just had it on, so it'll show you which mode the car is actually driving in. So just some cool features there. And then it has the normal things that you would see in all the rest of my Accords. You know, if you want your range, your tripometer information, that stuff. Scrolling down, fuel economy, speed and time. Traffic signs is really cool. Where that box is, you can actually see right there. It'll use the camera up in here. It's actually one of the cameras it uses for Honda sensing, so right here. And it will detect road signs and tell you what the speed limit is. So that way, if you pass one and you didn't see it, it'll let you know. So cool feature that our car comes with now. I just really like it. Driving support, this is gonna pull up. And get you some of your Honda sensing stuff too. Driver attention monitor, just make sure you're paying attention. It'll check in on you and alert you if you're not touching the steering wheel or the gas or brake if you're using all the Honda sensing stuff. So safety support and warnings, that's just general features. Moving back to the steering wheel, so you can see I have my plus and minus for my volume control. This is how I was toggling through that menu earlier. And then when I want something, I just select it. If I was listening to music, I could jump to my next track or jump to the next station from right here. My source button right here, this will toggle through whatever's on the screen. So FM and AM is all I have hooked up right now. If I had USB and Bluetooth and all that, that would toggle through there. Right here are my Bluetooth controls. So to answer a phone call, to hang up or go back, and then voice command. Same thing with all my other vehicles too. If I'm hooked up with Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, this would allow me access to OK Google and Siri. If I'm not hooked up through those, depending on if the car offers it or not, I still have access to Siri, which is kind of nice. You can ask Siri to call people, text people, that sort of thing. So just kind of a nice feature to know about. Moving over to the other side, this is where some of my Honda sensing features are gonna be. So to initially get them ready, I would press the main button. When I do that, you're gonna see ACC and LKAS come on. So that's what you see right there. And that stands for Adaptive Cruise Control and Lane Keep Assist. So, as far as adaptive cruise control, how that would work is once I get up to my speed I want to set, I would press set. From there, I can select the distance that it keeps between me and the car in front of me. And when I press this button, you'll see some boxes come on. The more boxes you see up there, the more space it's going to keep between you and the car in front of you. So that's how this function works. And it's using radar down in the grill to detect the car in front of you. The other one was lane keep assist. So how that one works is right here. And when I select this, you will see these dotted lines come on. So I'm making them flash back and forth. When they fill in solid, it means it's now reading the road. A couple things to keep in mind, it works from 45 miles an hour to 90 miles an hour. And then if your windshield wipers are on, it's gonna turn that function off. So it's gonna force you to hold the wheel and really pay attention. And that's just for safety's sake. So just be aware that's what's going on with that. Moving over to your touchscreen. So a touchscreen set up a lot like my other vehicles as far as my Accords. So not much different there. You can see I have my controls and everything right here. It's a base model, so it's not a touchscreen. When you move up, it'll become the touchscreen, and that's where you have access to Apple CarPlay and Android Auto and the models above it. But just for the sake of it, it's a nice large screen for things like when you throw your backup camera on and things like that. You've got a nice good screen here. I've got some different views that I can toggle between. So this one's aimed straight down. You can see the edge of my back bumper if I was parallel parking. So just some nice features that it has. One thing I will point out that's a little bit different from my other models is it does have the buttons as far as your shifter, whereas usually you'd find this on my higher speeded transmissions. On this vehicle, you'll see it from the base model and up. So it's got buttons as far as pushing, reversing, you pull back, neutral, and the drive button. Below that, you're going to see some buttons that are indicative of a couple different cars. So Econ mode, to improve gas mileage, you can press this whenever you do. You will see that green leaf come on. So you'll know that's on. You can turn it on and off whenever you want. How it works is it will improve gas mileage, but it will limit some things. So it's going to affect things like your AC unit when it's going full blast and your accelerator. So just be aware of that. It's going to limit things but improve gas mileage. Sport mode is kind of the opposite. It's actually going to cause the car to rev at a higher rate and give you a little bit more get up and go, but you're going to give up some of that gas mileage. So just be aware. It just depends on what you need at the time. EV mode, so this is going to switch over to strictly electric. The cool thing I like about this is when you turn it on, it'll alert you up here in the dash. You can see down in the bottom left area where it says EV. So see, I just turned it on right there. And what's cool about it is when it needs to switch over, it'll automatically do that. So if you get up to a speed where it's like, all right, I'm gonna switch over the gasoline engine, you don't have to worry about turning it on and off yourself. It'll do it for you. Or if you ran out of charge, it'll just automatically switch over. So it's just a nice feature that you don't have to worry about too much. You can just kind of keep it and press it and go. Your parking brake's electronic. To set it, you put your foot on the brake and you pull up to set it. When you do, you'll see the red LED come on here. To release it, put your foot on the brake and press down on the trigger to release it. So same as like using a handbrake. Brake hold. Really cool feature. It's really more of a convenience thing, but I just like the idea of it. When I'm in stop and go traffic, if I come to a complete stop while the car's in drive and this button is on, when I come to the stop, I can let off my foot off the brake and it will hold the brake even though the car's in drive. This feature doesn't work if you have your seatbelt off, so keep that in mind. If you're like going through a drive-through, you got to keep your seatbelt on if you want to be able to use this there too. Other than that, though, if you're in stop and go traffic, it's just nice to not have to like keep your foot pressed on the gas and the brake, gas brake. It just allows you to free up your leg a little bit and relax. As far as other things you can see in the car, pop open this little console right here and you've got a 12-volt power outlet and then a USB down in there. AC unit, I feel like, is pretty self-explanatory. It's dual-moded, but it's air, hot or cold, and where you want it to go. So that should be pretty easy to understand, I think, for most people. Center console, nice big armrest. And then you got some storage down there, and you have a 12-volt outlet down there also with a little sliding shelf. It's a base model, so this is a cloth interior. And this is actually I believe I'm in a black-on-black model. So you can see it's lined in black. My bottom floorboards are always black. My tops, my windows and dashes and seals are always black too to prevent glare. The only thing that would change, so if we were looking at a tan model, the seats would be tan. My armrests and center console, which actually I think my center console is going to stay black, and they usually do that so your elbows don't get them dirty. So that is a 2018 Honda Accord Hybrid base model. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. Comment on the YouTube video. You can always call me at 512-443-4300 and ask for Justin. Or you can email me, the letter J, and then Fuller, my last name. So J Fuller, F-U-L-L-E-R, at HowdyHonda.com. Thank you much.